नित्यानन्देश्वर परम शिव समारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Srimahans, Mahans, Thanidar, Kotari, visitors, viewers, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, Nityananda e-Gurukul students, Nityananda Hindu University students, and especially Lila Dhyan program participants. This session is going to be directly, specially, maybe I should say that exclusively focused for Lila Dhyan participants, for Lila Dhyan program participants. All the Lila Dhyan program participants, you are my personal guest in my own home. Welcome. Welcome home. And all those watching us live on Kailasas, NTV, YouTube Live, Facebook Live, Kailasa TV, Kailasas Hinduism Now TV, Kailasas Enlighten App, Twitter, and Kailasas Nayana Diksha. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, 6th day of the Rajarajeshwari Brahmotsavam, Sri Rajarajeshwari Nityanandeshwari Parashakti is gracing in Sarva Alankara, in Swarana Airavata Vahanam, along with Mahalakshmi and Mahasaraswati. And today is 4th day of the Vijayotsavam. Kalabhairava and Parashakti are gracing in Sarva Alankara, in Bhutavahanam, Rajatasimhavahanam, and Swaranahamsavahanam, in Adikailasa Nityananda Peetam. Let's receive their blessings now.
Om. धूरसि धूर्वधूर्वं तन्धूर्वतञो ओस्मान् धूर्वति तन्धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वामस्तं देवानामसि सस्तितमं पप्रितमञ्जुष्टतमं वह्नितमं देवहूतमहृतमसि हविर्थानन्त्रिकं हस्तमात्वा आर्मित्रस्य त्वाचक्षाप्रे क्षेमाभिर्मा संविक्थामात्वा हिगुंसितम्। ॐ श्रीनित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्ति राजराजेश्वरि महाधूपमाघ्रापयामि। ॐ ईप्यस्वजात वेदोपघन निरृतिम ममा पशुकिश्च मह्यम आवह जीवनं च दिशो दिश मानो हिगुंसि जात वेदो कामश्वं पुरुषं जगत् अभिभ्रदग्न आगहि श्रिया मा परिपातय। ओम श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्ति राजराजेश्वरि नमः एकहारति दीपं संदर्शयामि। ओम अमृते अमृतोद्भवे अमृतवर्षिणी अमृतं श्रावय श्रावय स्वाहा। ओम श्री नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्ति राजराजेश्वरि नमः नानाविधानि नैवेद्यानि निवेदयामि निवेदनानन्तरम् आचमनं समर्पयामि। ओम बहुपै बह्वश्वायै बह्वजाविकायै बहुव्रीह्यवायै बहुमाशतिलायै बहुहिरण्यायै बहुहस्तिकायै बहुदासपुरुषायै रैमत्यै पुष्टिमत्यै बहुरायस्पोषायै राजास्तु। गौरीमिमाय सलिलानितक्षत्येकपदी द्विपदी सा चतुष्पदी अष्टापदी नवपदी बभूषी सहस्रा अक्षरा परमे व्योमन् ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति राजराजेश्वरी नमः सर्वोपचार पूजार्थे सर्वापराध क्षमापनार्थे समस्त मंगल प्राप्त्यर्थे महामंगल नीराजनम संदर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि। भवानि त्वन्दासे मयि वितर दृष्टिं सकरुणां इति स्तोतुं वाञ्छन् कथयति भवानि त्वमिति यः तदैव त्वं तस्मै दिशसि निजसायुज्य पदवीं मुकुन्द ब्रह्मेन्द्र स्फुटमकुटनीराजित पदाम् दिशादीर्घीयस्या दरदलित नीलोत्पलरुचा दवीयां संदीनं नपय कृपया मामपि शिवे अनेनायं धन्यो भवति न च ते हानिर्यता वने वा हर्म्ये वा समकर निपातो हि मकरः। ओम धूरसि धूर्वधूर्वं तन्धूर्वतयोऽस्मान् धूर्वति तन्धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वामस्मन् देवानामस्यस्थितमं वप्रितमञ्जुष्टतमं वह्नितमं देवभूतमवस्तमति अविर्धानन्द्रगं हत्वमाह्वार्मित्रस्य त्वाचक्षाप्रेक्षेमाभिर्मासंस्था मात्वाहिंसम्। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति नमः। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव कालभैरव स्वामिने नमः। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः। धूपमाक्षापयामि। ओम दीप्यस्वजातवेदो पघ्नं निरृतिम्बमा पशुभिश्चमह्यमावह जीवनं चक्षोदिश मानो हि गुंति जातवेदो कामश्रं पुरुषं जगत् अभिभ्रदघ्नागहिस्या मा परिपातय। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति नमः। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव कालभैरवस्वामिने नमः। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः। एकहारती दीपं संदर्शयामि। ओम अमृते अमृतोद्भवे अमृतवर्षिणी अमृतं श्रावय श्रावय स्वाहा। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति नमः। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव कालभैरवस्वामिने नमः। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः। नानाविधानि नैवेद्यानि निवेदयामि निवेदनानन्तरं आचमनं समर्पयामि। ओम सर्वस्याप्यै सर्वस्य चित्त्यै सर्वमेव तेनाप्नोति सर्वं जयति अघोरेभ्यो थकोरेभ्यो घोरघोरतरेभ्यः सर्वेभ्यः सर्वशर्वेभ्यो नमस्ते अस्तु रुद्ररूपेभ्यः। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति नमः। ओम श्री नित्यानंदेश्वर परमशिव कालभैरवस्वामिने नमः। सर्वदेवदेवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः। सर्वोपचार पूजार्थे सर्वापराध क्षमापनार्थे समस्त मंगल प्राप्त्यर्थे महामंगल नीराजनं संदर्शयामि रक्षां धारयामि।
Paramashiva's message directly from Sri Kailasa. Listen, today's message is specially for the participants of Leela Dhyana program. Listen, my Leela, my life is one of the greatest strong nuclear force, positive explosion from Sri Kailasa directly on this universe. My life is not made of just few incidents. Listen, how will you write the history of a powerful, strong nuclear forces explosion? Not negatively, positive explosion. This whole universe, what you know, planet Earth, Sun, Moon, everything, is the outcome of that strong nuclear force explosion. Big Bang. How will you write the history of Big Bang? Only based on the impact it left. The history of the Big Bang, story of the Big Bang can be penned down. Same way, the huge positive impact I am making and continue to make, the totality of all that put together only, my life can be described. Understand, I am a strong nuclear force explosion from Sri Kailasa directly. I am neither pride about it nor humble about it. I am neither going to hide it nor going to over spell it, decorate it with words. I can neither overspell, decorate, and nor interested in hiding. I am straight, unhideable, huge, positive, strong nuclear force explosion on this universe. I am here to make you all experience, make us all radiate Paramashiva, the absolute and ultimate conscious possibility. Understand? My words are neither poetry nor prose or logical or magical or theory or philosophy. It is straight from the heart of the Paramashiva to the straight to the heart of my disciples. It's from heart to heart, Paramashiva's heart to your heart. Listen, my guru Vibhudanandapuri Kuppammal, she used to say, I am the explosion happened in Arunachala Linga, the Arunachaleshwara. And she used to say, she brought that explosion through Mahakala Bhairava in Arunachaleshwara temple. There is a beautiful Mahakala Bhairava with 8 hands on the banks of Brahmadirtham, the temple tank. And she said she brought through that Mahakala Bhairava's deity and kept it in Brahmatirtham to cool off, to settle, then brought it to my mother's womb. And she says my mother's womb and my father's body both were prepared at the same time. Then through father's body, the male component was brought into my mother's womb and I was given form and manifested. Understand? I want all of you to go and have darshan of Arunachaleshwara, main deity, and that Kalabhairava. And she said that is the reason on Ashtami Tithi, I assumed the farm, and she wrote off all her wealth to that Kalabhairava deity. I don't know how many of you know, when I did not want to accept her properties and the ashram she built for me in my name legally, she said, I am putting it in the name of Kalabhairava. One day he will get it back to you. He will give it back to you. He will protect till the day it has to reach you, and then he will hand it over to you. It has to come to you only. With that declaration, she put it in the name of Kalabhairava. Even now, that property which she lived, she wanted to give it to me, is in the name of that Kalabhairava deity. And she has made a will that every Ashtami, that puja should happen for that Kalabhairava. And the Navaratri Ashtami day, Navaratri 8th day, Ashtami day, puja for that Kalabhairava and Parashakti, both. She made a will and then the property is given. Still, that property is with the deity name only. So and she also made the whole story, a detailed write-up. It's there. Anyhow, I want all of you to go and have darshan of Arunachaleshwara main deity and the Kalabhairava deity. And exact replica of that deity only is made and installed in Bididi. And that deity's replica only is made as Kalabhairava, Mahakalabhairava, and given to all our temples with 8 hands and Kalabhairava chakra, Mahakalabhairava chakra behind the deity. That is the deity. Understand, I am a most powerful, strong nuclear force, positive explosion. Only based on the effect, impact I create on all of you and in the universe, the result only can be described as my story. How will you write the history of a lightning? Tell me. How will you? No. Based on the impact it makes, you pin down the history of lightning. Same way. Just only based on the impact. I call it Divya Sarira I am making in each one of you. Only that, only through that collective narration of the impact I make on this universe can only be described, used to detail my story. I can give you some incidents. Of course, you will be hearing a lot of incidents from my blood relatives, family, friends. I tell you, every person who walks in the street in Thiruvannamalai will have some story about me. They are so happy to connect some way. They'll tell my fathers, grandfathers, grandsons, cousins, second sisters, third granddaughters, fathers. 5th grandson is a classmate of Swamiji. They are so happy that there is some connection. And just like how I celebrate Thiruvannamalai, Thiruvannamalai celebrates me. You will hear a lot of stories, a lot of incidents. An ordinary photographer who has a small photograph shop, a small rented property, just 20 feet by 20 feet. He has not only stories, thorough evidence that he has seen with his own eyes, Raghupati Yogi levitating, me levitating, Raghupati Yogi trying to photograph when I am levitating, and that whole, all the that photographer's assistants got frightened, ran away, and that the photograph did not fall. the body was in such high frequency, light can never be captured by the camera, and the photograph did not come out. It was just empty. Then again, they have to click, making me sit on the ground. You will hear every person telling the stories. We have at least 3 eyewitness. One person who makes flower garland in Thiruvannamalai temple, Krithigai Mandapam. Second, the photographer who took the photograph of Arunagiri Yogi and me. Third, Raghupati Yogi's son. All these 3 of them are the eyewitness for me levitating, floating on the air. You can see all of them. You can get the narration from each of them directly. You can enjoy the stories. And Leelas. And you should all visit my guru's samadhis. The yoga lingam we installed on my guru, Yogi Raghupati Yogi, Yogananda Puri Samadhi, and Vibhudananda Puri Samadhi. We have installed Shivalingam, and there are so many other places to be seen in Thiruvannamalai associated to my life. You should also visit the Anandaganda Guha, the cave of Arunachaleshwara's Anandaganda, through which Arunagiri Yogishwara used to take me. See, he will walk me into his samadhi and get me out through the Arunagiri Yogish, the Anandaganda Guha. We have one photograph taken on me sitting on that cave. The cave is just near the Skandashram of Ramanashram. Ramanashram has a branch on the hill called Skandashram, where Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi sat for a long time, lived for a long time. Just near that Skandashram, that Anandaganda Guha, the cave of Anandaganda of Arunachala is there. You should all visit that place also. And continuously there is a natural waterfall, water fountain. It used to be live 365 days waterfall in those days. I don't know now whether it is still live, but surely there is a small water pond. It used to be there. As long as I lived in Arunachala, it was gift from Arunagiri Yogishwara for me, because I used to go there and sit and meditate for a long time and sit in samadhi with Arunagiri Yogishwara, oneness in Arunagiri Yogishwara. You should visit all those places. It will be intensely charging experience to hear the stories and eyewitness. See, one thing, the innocent, straightforward, heart-to-heart narration from those small town villagers, it has become town only now. In those days when I was born and brought up, it was not a town. It was a little bigger village, that's all. As per Indian standard, it was only a little bigger village, that's all. It was not a town. So, the innocent, straightforward, heart-to-heart stories from those villages, that is the authenticity of that stories. Authenticity of that stories. Understand? Nothing can corrupt those villagers How much ever they hear from the media, they don't care. They say very clearly, hey, we know Swamiji. He grew up here. And they don't even say he grew up here. They always say, we brought him up. Every villager in Thiruvannamalai, whether he is a small fruit shop vendor or seller of camphor, everyone will have some story. And I tell you, all of them have brought me up. All of them are directly involved in bringing me up. All of them have brought me up. It is extreme love, care, and that spiritual ecosystem of Thiruvannamalai. There is a temple called Vallabhai Ganapati Temple. From my home, through that way only I have to go to that VDS Jain school where I used to study. It's near a cinema theatre called Pugal Cinema Theatre. In those days the cinema theatre was there. Now I don't think the theatre exists. And the Sannidhithir, the straight street in front of the temple, there is a temple called Vallabhai Ganapati Temple. Those days there used to be an old lady who used to make idlis and sell outside the temple on the street. Every day she will be ready with the pack of idlis tied in banana leaf and small vessel with sambar. When I go to school, without forgetting even a single day, she will give that for me. And many days I will not go to school. She will come in search of me where I am. She knows my regular hideouts in temple. Either under the, in temple there is a banyan tree. Under that banyan tree I will be there. Or in Kritike Mandapam. She will come regularly. If I don't show up by 7:30. See, 8 o'clock the school starts. 7:30 if I don't show up in that temple, she knows I am not going to come to school. By 8:15, she will start walking. And by that 8:15, her business also will settle down. Morning, it will be done. So she will come and hand over the idli and her sambar to me. Then she will go around the temple and go back to her temple. She used to live in that temple. And then she will have two sessions. Morning, one session, making idli and selling, and evening bonda. She will start preparing for her evening sales. I don't remember her missing this even one day till I left Thiruvannamalai. Maybe you guys will be fortunate that still she is alive. If you guys go to that Vallabhai Ganapati temple, her name is just the local village name, Idli Party. That's the name I remember. She had a small shop. There's every possibility she may be still living there and making idlis and selling. Because in Thiruvannamalai people don't die so easily, so quickly. They live for a long time. My mother's mother, I think last 6 or 7 years she was diagnosed with cancer. No treatment, nothing. I just gave my hand key to her. She is using my hand key under her pillow. That is the only treatment. No other medicine, nothing. She is still living. She is living. No chemo, nothing. No surgery, nothing. I have seen her mother alive. Thiruvannamalai people don't die that easily. They live for a long time. I have seen at least 50 people lived more than 100 years. 50 people, men and women, lived more than 100 years. And at least 100 people who lived above 95. Like they will die after 95, before 100. 100 people I have seen. 50 people I have seen who lived above 100 years. in Tiruvannamalai village alone. I am not talking about outside, just in Tiruvannamalai. I have seen at least 50 enlightened beings radiating Paramashiva living in Tiruvannamalai. That ecosystem is symbol of enlightenment, health, longevity, all the best things I am radiating, I am teaching to the world. Forget about all the stories you are going to hear, all that is one side. That very air you are breathing for 7 days is extreme blessing in your life. The ultimate blessing in your life I'll make you all experience the positive explosion Paramashiva is exploding as this being Nityananda Paramashivam yesterday the musicians who came and played Nadaswaram and Tavil for all you guys, the same person played for my father and mother's marriage. If you see the photograph of my parents' marriage album, you will see the same person. His son, grandson, all that whole Vamsa is our devotees. The same person only played for my father's marriage. So nothing changes in that village. If you go, you will meet the same people. If you go to the school, you will meet the same headmasters, teachers. Maybe some of them died, but still surely there will be few. If you go to the shops, you will feel most of that same person or his son. Nothing changes in Tiruvannamalai. I always used to say, even today, without any support, I can deliver post in Tiruvannamalai because I know every house, address, name of the person, his son, his daughter-in-law, how much dowry they got when they got married, and who is married to whom, and even who is having affair with whom, who had affair with whom. And who is living with whom, and where, whose son is married, whose daughter is married to whom. It's a too sweet place to live, and especially growing up, and it's not just innocence of human beings, it is a spiritual strength of that place, that spiritual stamina. I should tell you, one of my grandfather, my mother's father's younger brother, his name is Annamalai. He is called Express Annamalai. Nickname is Express Annamalai because he will walk so fast, like a lightning only he will move. The whole village knows him because of his fast walking. Every day morning, with his fast walk, he will walk up to temple, have darshan of Arunachaleshwara. Not single day he will miss. He will walk up to Arunachaleshwara, have darshan, go back to his office. My mother's father and he, both of them had same office. Means they were partners. It's a family business. They were together. Then my grandfather's son and his son, they are partners. It's like a family firm. I want to tell you guys, ఈవెన్ మోడర్న్ డే దిస్ మోడర్న్ డే పీపుల్ హూ డెడికేటెడ్ దేర్ లైఫ్ ఫర్ ఎన్లైటన్మెంట్ ఈవెన్ దే విల్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ సచ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ అ ఇంటెన్సిటీ అండ్ స్టెబిలిటీ ఇన్ దేర్ స్పిరిచువల్ ప్రాక్టీస్ అండ్ రొటీన్ powerful cognitions as part of everyday life my grandmother see actually I should narrate this family tree then you will understand my mother's father and my father's mother are brother and sisters brother and sister my mother's father father's mother it's like a internally inside family they marry every person you meet they will be related to me in five ways they will tell the five kind of a relationship or the channel through which they are related to me and each of them see it is not that too much of spiritual practice or all that can be described but the powerful cognitions they carried my grandmother actually she had heart attack in the morning maybe around 6 o'clock she got up and said inform swamiji I am going to die today he should liberate me and then she started getting ready to go to the temple on her own my grandmother's daughter means my atte my father's sister she said what do you mean you are saying you are going to die and you are getting ready to go to the temple she said yes yes how can I die without going to temple and have Arunachalishwara's darshan you inform swamiji she went to temple came back had her darshan and came back she did all her morning she used to have her own small puja she did everything and then she had her own cooking she had the style of the it's called swayambhavam you see once your husband dies you take a vav of vanaprastha and in Hindu tradition and you cook on your own and eat you don't eat the food cooked by others it's called swayambhaga she has taken that vow she has taken that vrata initiation and she lived as a vanaprasthi a very perfect vanaprasthi and she had her own cooking and ate and then she used to enjoy that Kumbakonam degree coffee and she made her coffee and drank and then by noon 2 o'clock she informed she asked the daughter have you informed swamiji they said yes we informed and she just lied down and left the body nothing else no hospital nothing no falling sick nothing she left the body the way you leave the body decides the way you lived the way you leave the body that is the scale to decide how you lived Still I remember every person in that local village they will call her ma if you come and touch everything will go auspicious please come and inaugurate the local shops even when they go for the new house griha pravesam they will call her you come and walk into the house first they will bring the cow and calf she has to hold the rope and walk usually the widows are not considered auspicious in Hindu tradition but my grandmother was never considered as a widow she was only considered as one of the yoginis and she will walk into the house first holding the rope of the cow and calf everywhere I have seen the way she was respected every house shop everywhere just because of her powerful cognition and the feeling connection she had with Arunachaleshwara. Arunachaleshwara was the center of life for the whole village. Even now, see, if you hear the narrative of the village, how in America and all you call it theme of your county, narrative of your county, each American county or the city will have its own narrative or the theme of your county, narrative of your county. They have special words for all these. If you see in Thiruvannamalai, the theme of the whole village, theme of the whole village and narrative of the whole village, everything is Arunachaleshwara. It is Arunachaleshwara, everything. The hill is Annamalai, the deity is Annamalai, and the village name is Annamalai, Thiruvannamalai. That's all. Thiru is just the title, like a Shri in Sanskrit, Mr. in English. If you see, hill name, Mr. Annamalai, Thiruvannamalai. Deity name, Mr. Annamalayar, Thiruvannamalayar. And the village name, the place name, Thiruvannamalai. That's all. All three same name. Because the theme of the whole village, the narrative of the whole village, if you go to every home, you will have one person named Annamalai. My father's father name is Annamalai. My father name is Arunachalam, which is the Sanskrit of Annamalai. That's all. Go to every house, you will have one Annamalai. There will not be any ration card without one Annamalai in Thiruvannamalai. Pick up any ration card of any home, there will be one Annamalai or one Arunachalam or one Abhidagujambal. Either one Annamalai or one Arunachalam or one Abhidagujambal or one Unnamalai. This, see, Annamalai, Sanskrit name is Arunachalam. Unnamalai, that mother's name, her Sanskrit name is Abhidagujambal. These four, one name will be there in every ration card of Thiruvannamalai. Because the narrative of that whole village is Arunachala. There will not be a single ration card. I can tell with all my confidence. There will not be a single ration card in that whole village without these four names. Annamalai, Arunachalam, Abhidagujambal, Unnamalai. That is the that is the narrative theme of that whole village. If we are born, worship is offered to Arunachala. When we leave the body, moksha deepam is offered to Arunachala. That's all. If the moksha deepam is lit on the temple tower, we know somebody has left the body in Thiruvannamalai. So you should all visit the Jiva Samadhis of all my three gurus who brought me up. Isakki Swami, Raghupati Yogi and Kuppammal. We have installed Yoga Lingam on Raghupati Yogi's Samadhi. And Isakki Swamigal Jiva Samadhi and Kuppammal's Jiva Samadhi. All the three are personally installed by me, and you should all have darshan of all the three Jiva Samadhis. I don't think I will end this session, this satsang, talking about Thiruvannamalai and me. It is the subject of the heart. Which I will never end. It will go on and on and on and on and on forever. And you should also visit Arunagiri Yogeshwara's Jiva Samadhi. So today, at least 4 Jiva Samadhis. Arunagiri Yogeshwara, then Raghupati Yogi, Isakki Swamigal, Kuppammal, Mada Vibhudanandapuri. Should visit all the 4 Jiva Samadhis. And also visit the Ayyarangal Mandapam, where Acharya Abhishekam was done for me formally. In those days it used to be open, and maybe you can ask the temple permission and take them to the Ayyarangal Mandapam, where Acharya Abhishekam was done for me in those days formally. And I'll go on and on and on. So today I'll just give this introduction. Maybe I can do one thing. The daytime or evening, we can have one session where I'll sit with you all and have coffee. Bhaktika, you should make all the local dishes, the Thiruvannamalai dishes. The Kanchipuram idli is very popular in Thiruvannamalai. It's called Kanchipuram idli. They make it with a small bamboo basket type. You should make that idli and feed everyone. Make all that local dishes, that kelvaragu kool. If you ask my mother, she will tell all those local popular dishes. I think you can call my mother. She can be there for that 7 days and make all that local dishes and take people around. When you guys go, she can also accompany all of you if her health permits. My mother is healthy. You can take her around and she can especially tell all that local dishes, variety of the dishes. You should make all of that and feed everyone for them to have the taste of Thiruvannamalai. Taste of Thiruvannamalai. And I also give you guys my boon. Understand, listen. Don't wear any form of footwear in Thiruvannamalai. Thiruvannamalai is literally energy, power. Don't wear any form of footwear. No shoes, no chappal. Don't wear anything. I tell you, you will be so charged, energized, radiating the current of Thiruvannamalai, the power of Thiruvannamalai. I never wear any footwear, any form of footwear in Thiruvannamalai. Only recently, after the Sangha started, the feet has become very soft. So I started wearing sometimes this rubber thing, that also rarely. When I walk in the tar road, otherwise inside ashram, I'll never, inside that open land, I never wear anything. Tar road is like a chemical road, so I started wearing a few days recently. When I lived in Thiruvannamalai, I never ever any footwear, any time. If If you talk to my mother, she will tell the story. I'll carry the shoe in my hand carry. Only after crossing Thiruvannamalai through bus, I'll wear. Before entering Thiruvannamalai, I'll remove and put it in the carry bag. People used to laugh. So even when I come in the car, before the Thiruvannamalai border, I'll remove the footwear. The moment I remove the footwear, they know the Thiruvannamalai border has come. So do not wear any form of footwear in Thiruvannamalai. It is intense energy field. And I'll tell Bhaktika to organize fire walking. Don't worry. I am there with you guys. Even if you have small wounds by that fire walking, it's hardly 11 feet. You will not die. I am telling you. It will be such powerful purification and detox process. Trust me and walk on that 11 feet live charcoal. It is done very systematically and traditionally. See, the fire invoking, everything is done very traditionally, very orthodox way, and that music they will create, it's called Pambai and Udukkai. It will raise your whole lymph node. Understand that lymph node is the purification system. Actually, you will hear that sound in your lymph node. It will hit your lymph node and activate it. The whole detoxing, cleansing system will become alive. Then when you walk on that fire for 11 feet, even if there is a small wound, all the toxins will leave your system, I tell you. All the toxins got into your body because of the chemicals in the food and unnecessary medicines, poisons poured in your body, whole thing will be detoxed. See, you are my personal guest in my home. I will not torture you. I will not really torture you. You are my guest. If I am telling you walk on fire for 11 feet, it is really to do so much good to you. Trust me and do it. I'll organize 7th day, last day. Trust me and do it. Even if you have small, you will not have any wounds. I'll take care. I'll hold your feet when you are walking on the fire. Even if you have small wound, nothing to worry. It'll only detox your body. I tell you, I will give you the taste of the whole Thiruvannamalai. All the best things I had, that small lemon piercing, I will provide. You decide whether you want to have. I'm not going to force. But I'll provide everything. I'll tell Bhaktika to arrange. There will be special smoke they will create in Thiruvannamalai temple. I'll get that same person, same Kungiliyam person, and make that same special smoke during the meditation process or that firewalking session. I'll get the same people who do that firewalking for last, I don't know how many thousands of years, for generations. Same people do. When I was young, I used to walk regularly. Even, I think, 2-3 years before recently, or 2-4 years before recently, we did in Thiruvannamalai. The same family only came and did. I'll call the same people and provide the same taste of everything. That lemon piercing and fire walking, everything I'll organize. Understand? When you are in my home, I will not torture you. And I am not sadist. You are all my guests. Whatever I am organizing, even if it is little, so-called not comfortable, just go through it, I tell you. I'll do only good to you. It will do so much good to you. That smoke, that sound. See, you have that lymph system, which is that like a cleaning system, detox system of your body, that gets ferociously awakened with that pambai udukai sound. It does so much cleaning. And when you walk on fire after that, it does so much cleaning. I will provide best loving, caring ambience for you to go through whatever I went through in Trivannamalai and taste the whole Trivannamalai. Taste the whole Trivannamalai. And I'll have one dinner with you guys and describe some personal stories, some intimate stories with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, which I can't describe in public. See, my relationship with Arunagiri Yogeshwara, if I describe in public, the stupid dogs will write all stupid theories. Oh, it is child abuse. All these donkeys. Let these dogs die with their theories of ideas of child abuse and everything. I will describe my relationship with my guru, my Arunagiri Yogeshwara, very sweetly as it happened. And who cares about these stupid dogs? Many times my gurus have slapped me. And I am happy about it. I am happy about it. And I am proud about it. I had relationship with my gurus so sweet and so empowering me. And such intimate. And they have slapped me and I am very happy about it. We Indians, we don't kill our kids by drugging them, putting psychiatric drugs and all these, calling hyperactive on all these false psychology, psychiatric diagnosis and dumping psychiatric drugs and completely sedating them and destroying their life. No. If they are throwing tantrum, we just give 2 slap. And they are brought to understanding and simply they behave properly. That's all. And we don't do all this roundabout destroying and calling that as a care. We don't know all this 2G, 3G, 4G in all those days. We only know Pitaji. And if we throw tantrum, Guruji. That's all. And we lived a happy life. And fortunately, those days, no POSCO, all that stupid nonsense, destroying the Indian culture and the science of bringing up children. And I'll tell you exactly how my gurus have brought me up. And my father and mother never used to slap because they are always afraid of me. They know that I am an incarnation. But my gurus have slapped me. And I am happy about it. And I am feeling very proud about it. See, when you see my mother, how she stands in front of my deity with so much of devotion, obedience, all that. That is the exact same way she used to stand in front of me. Even when I was a kid and her son. That's the exact way she used to stand. So I don't find any difference in her. When I saw her, when I was 4 or 14, 40, same. I don't see any difference in her. Now how she stands in front of my deity, that's the exact way she will stand in front of me. as even when I was a kid, at the age of 4 or 5 or whatever. So, I want you guys to taste Thiruvannamalai in every way. I'll organize everything. All you guys should know, this 7-day program, I am personally guiding, deciding every step who should come to receive you guys. Everything I am personally managing. It is like a, you guys are my personal guests. Menu, everything. I am personally pushing, working with Bhaktika. Almost 24/7, I think Bhaktika is not sleeping because whole day and night I am constantly in touch with her, forcing her, hey, do this, do that. Of course, she is also inspired and she is doing, she is not resisting and she has really taken it up as a tyaga. And if there is something which is not up to the scale, it is like a just our inability means that she is not able to pull. Otherwise, she is very sincere. She is absolutely committed and sincere to make all you guys experience Arunachala. And Arunachala's expression as Nityananda Paramashivam, she is committed. And I am so happy about it. I am so happy about it. And I'll do everything. And I also told her that to get all the archives items, like all the cloth given to me by Arunagiri Yogeshwara is in Bididi. All those, whatever I received from my gurus, many were burnt by those, the anti-Hindu elements, when they attacked me in Thiruvannamalai. We lost a lot of things. And even in Bididi, when they burnt my quarters, my room, in 2010, we lost a lot of things. But whatever remaining, we have stored, kept everything safely in Bididi. I told Bhaktika to get all of it and show you guys. And see everything and enjoy. And I have so much to tell you guys. And I'll tell them to organize Abhishegam in Arunachalishwara temple. And all you guys can enjoy that Abhishegam and temple prasadam. So much to tell. Bhaktika, in that the Thirumanjana Gopurathu ulpakkam irukkira gopuram therkku kattai gopurathula dhaan na Mauna Swami Narayana Swami ukkandirupaaru. Ippovum oru chinna avarudaiya avar irundha edathila oru chinna na mukkona kal maari pratishtha pannirukanga oru chinna sila avara represent panni take them to that place also. That is considered to be his jeeva samadhi. Even though he left the body and the body is taken away to Kanyakumari, he used to sit there and he blessed that lingam, that deity, as his jiva samadhi. Take them there and show. That Swami gave me this Nirahara Samyama science, the science of Nirahara Samyama. He is the father of Nirahara Samyama. See, whatever today I am sharing with the whole world, the Nityananda Yoga's father is Raghupati Yogi, and the whole mantra, tantra and Vedanta, the mother is Mata Kuppammal, power manifestation science. The father is Arunagiri Yogeshwara, and the science of unclutching, Nirvikalpa Samadhi, father is Isakki Swamigal, and Nirahara Samyama, the father is The Mauna Swami, who used to sit inside the Terku Kattai Goburam. There was two Mauna Swami. One used to sit in Thirumanjana Goburam Madil. Another one used to sit in Terku Kattai Goburam. Terku Kattai Goburam, that Swami, Narayana Swami, is the father of the Nirahara Samyama and father of that oneness science which I am teaching, that 360 degree vision. Annamalai Swamigal, you should take them to even Annamalai Swamigal Jiva Samadhima. It is inside Ramanashram. Ramanashram will allow. They are allowing people to go and have darshan of Annamalai Swamigal. You should take all of them and show them Ramanashram and Annamalai Swamigal's Jiva Samadhi. Even Thinnai Swamigal. The Thinnai where Thinnai Swami used to sit. I don't know, still he is in the body. I think he left the body. But the Thinnai is there still. They are keeping it as his memorial with the photograph. And Sadhu Om. You should also visit Sadhu Om's Jiva Samadhi. Sadhu Om's Samadhi is still there. And Muruganar Samadhi. Muruganar I have not met physically. But Sadhu Om I have met physically. And Annamalai Swami I have met physically. And there used to be another one, elderly lady Kanagammal. I used to regularly visit her to listen about Ramanashram and Ramana Maharshi. She wrote commentary on Arunachala Pancharatnam, written by Ramana Maharshi. You should visit all those places. Oh God, I don't think 7 days will be sufficient to taste Arunachala. You should have at least next program make it as 10 days, ma. I don't think 7 days will be sufficient because I myself need 7 days for you guys. For me to tell you all the stories, I need 7 days. And also fix this 10 days. See, this whenever you have this Leela Dhyan program, I will not give any other program. I'll cancel all other programs because I need to spend time with the Leela Dhyan participants. I need to sit with all of them and tell all the stories. And as I said, all other programs are built on words. Leela Dhyan is built on my life, which I lived and living. This program is built on my life, my flesh and blood and bones, living. Embodied Guru. You see, all other programs are built on words, principles, philosophies, tattva. But this program is built on embodied Guru. Flesh and bones, living Paramashiva. So, next program, make it as 10 days. And the 10 days, no other program. Only morning satsang and this Leela Dhyan program. So my 10 days, I wanted to make it exclusive. So whenever people are not going for sightseeing, the Leela Sthanas visit, I want to sit with them. And also make that local varakapi. Varakapi is that milk, coffee without milk. That varakapi will take away all the sleep. Make it in a local way. You see, if you ask my mother, she will tell how my grandmother used to make. There is a special recipe. It's called that Kumbakonam filter. See, it'll have two layer brass pot. In that they will do that filtering. That decoction you should make, that is called varakapi. And no milk is added. No milk is added. You should give them that varakapi. You should also take them to the local Udipi hotel and give them one breakfast or lunch there. He is our devotee. And such, you see, such honest business people, such extremely honest business people, you should meet them. If I had 100 meal from my mother, I would have had at least 50 meal from that Udupi hotel. Because every day my guru will hold my hand and take me and have at least one cup of coffee there. I still remember that time I was so small that chair used to be tall for me. So my guru will lift me, Raghupati Yogi will lift me and make me sit on the table. Sit on the table and drink coffee. From that time, I started going to his hotel. He may even tell, because there used to be one table reserved for my guru. That is the table on which I used to sit. You see, because the chair used to be tall for me. I can't climb on the chair and sit. My guru will lift me and put me on the table. And he will have his coffee and I used to have his coffee. Without missing a single day. And still he is alive. The owner of the hotel is still alive and he is running the hotel. I want you all to go and visit that hotel and have one. Bhaktika, keep this as a tradition. At least one meal. In Udupi hotel. Don't bring from there. Go to that hotel and eat. Because that place is sacred. That place is sacred. Go to the hotel and eat. At least one lunch. And that person is sacred. You should know. Such pious people, I can't imagine. Such honesty. Integrity to the profession. See, I have been with them from the time I know me. Not even one small cheating they will do. Even during the mass crowd comes, the temple festival time also, they will not compromise on quality. Whether rice, ingredients, cooking method, that professional integrity and honesty. Bhaktika, you should take them to the hotel and give lunch there. In Udupi, Ubatyaya's hotel. I think now too many Udupi hotels have come, but what I am saying is Udupi Ubatyaya. His hotel, you should take them and give them lunch. I think it's more than 1.5 hours. Other people who are attending the morning satsang should go and carry on with their routine. So just for the other people, I'll give a break now. But I'm going to come back to be with you guys. I'm going to come back, and when you guys are back from all the Leelasthana visit, I'm going to come back and tell you guys how my gurus brought me up. I will have one theme every day. How my gurus brought me up. I'll tell those stories. And how I miss my gurus. I'll tell you that stories. See, it's like only by narrating the memories I lived with them, I relive and enjoy my gurus. Understand, I am a simple being. My guru bhakti and all can never be taken away. Even all my Vedantic oneness, complete Paramashivatva, I still retain my guru bhakti, my personal love for my gurus. Understand, my cosmic love does not mean my personal love disappears. No. My personal love for my gurus is like a wave in the ocean of cosmic love. My cosmic oneness with my guru, you see, my oneness with Arunagiri Yogeshwara is like a ocean. My personal love for my Arunagiri Yogeshwara is like a waves. Waves don't disappear when ocean happens. Waves exist with ocean. So how I miss my gurus, Arunagiri Yogeshwara? Only by remembering those stories, telling their memories with me, telling my life with them, I feel myself. So it is personal love. Understand? Not like your Vedantic stupid, cosmic, juju, formless love and all that. Stupid. I am not cheap fellow to get cheated by stupid Vedantic theories. I am a simple, straightforward villager. Personal love. Literally, they fed me my breakfast. I tasted their fingers along with idli. Understand? When they fed me, I am not a Vedantic guy. Oh, Guru Tattva, let me be integrated to Guru Tattva. Get out of my life. Go and do what you want. I am a simple village boy. Deep personal attachment to Arunagiri Yogeshwara, my guru, and simple obedience. And and I'll carry food for Arunagiri Yogeshwara just because he will feed me. When he eats, he will give me also 2-3 morsels. Just for that only I'll carry. And make sure that food is like a sticky food. Like sakra pongal, that kind of a sticky food. Because, see, if it is a idli, it will be like a piece. I can't bite his finger. I can't taste his finger. If it is a licky, that a sticky food, like a sakra pongal, I'll force my mother to make that kind of that food which sticks in the finger. Alva, sakra pongal, that kind of food which sticks in the finger. So I'll hold his finger and completely taste the finger along with the food. I lived that kind of a simple, very intimate life with my gurus. And of course, this modern day humanity is neither going to have that kind of guru, nor going to have that kind of intimate relationship, nor going to be brought up by the gurus. That I don't know. I don't know whether humanity lost it or I don't know. All right. Forget about all that. I will tell you as it happened. And I don't care about all these stupid fellows and what theories they try to build and all that stupidity. I used to force my mother, hey, you make all that sticky type of food which sticks in the finger. So when he eats and then when he feeds me, I'll hold the finger. In the name of that food did not come completely into my mouth and I'll taste his finger. That kind of a very sweet, intimate life I lived with him. And it's a relationship of Navarasa. All best things. All best things of life. And I'll tell all the stories. I'll share with you guys. And today I'll connect all of you with living embodied guru, Paramashiva. Not just some principle, ideas, theories, words. Living embodied guru. Listen, if you want your mind to manifest Paramashiva, just have words, principles. If you want your body to manifest Paramashiva, have physical embodied guru and live around him. Taste him, enjoy him, live around him, serve him, celebrate him physically. So I'll today connect with you guys the physical manifestation of Paramashiva. Nityananda Paramashivam. Now, with the grace of Paramashiva, I'll connect all of us to the living embodied Guru Paramashiva as Nityananda Paramashivam. If you have Atmalinga, take it in your hand, keep it in your hand and sit connecting with embodied Guru. Chant the Mahavagya intensely and start.
बंधवे नमो I'm not afraid to die. स्फुट विकट मुखम भास्कर भीम रूपम रुंडमालम रवितम नियतम ताम्र नेत्रम कराळम नम 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 नग्नभूषं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालं बम बम वायुवेगं नतजन सदयं ब्रह्मसारं परन्तं खं 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 खड्गहस्तं त्रिभुवन विलयं भास्करं भीमरूपं चं 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 चलित्वा चल चल चलिता चालितं भूमिचक्रम् मायि रूपं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालम् शं 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 शङ्खहस्तं शशिकरधवलं मोक्षसम्पूर्णतेजम् महान्तं कुलमकुलकुलं मन्त्रगुप्तं सुनित्यं यं 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 भूतनाथं किलिकिलिकिलितं बालकेलिप्रधानम् अं 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 अन्तरिक्षं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालम् खड्गभेदं विषममृतमयं कालकालं कराणम् छं 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 क्षिप्रवेगं दह दह दहनं तप्तसन्दीप्यमानम् हौं 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 कारनादं प्रकटितगहनं खड्जितैर्भूमिकम्पम् बं 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 बाललीलं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालम् सिद्धियोगं सकल गुणमखं देवदेवं प्रसन्नम् पं 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 पद्मनाभं हरिहरमयनं चन्द्रसूर्याग्निनेत्रम् ऐं 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 ऐश्वर्यनाथं सतत भयहरं पूर्वदेवस्वरूपम् रौं 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 रौद्ररूपं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालम् हंसयानं हपितकलहकं मुक्तयोगात्तहासं हं 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 नेत्ररूपं शिरमकुटजटाबन्धबन्धाग्रहं हं हं कारनादं विदशलकलटं कामधर्मापहारं हुं 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 भूतनाथं प्रणमत सततं भैरवं क्षेत्रपालम्
पंकजं व्यालयज्ञ सूत्रमिन्दुशेखरं कृपाकरं नारदादि योगी वृंदवंदितं दिगंबरं काशिकापुराधिनाथ कालभैरवं भजे भानुकोटि भास्वरं भवाब्धितारकं परं कालकालमम्बुजाशमक्षशूलमक्षरं काशिकापुराधिनाथ कालभैरवं भजे शूलटङ्कपाशदण्डपाणिमादिकारणं श्यामकायमादि భీమ విక్రమం ప్రభుం విచిత్ర తాండవ ప్రియం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. భక్తి ముక్తిదాయకం ప్రశస్త చారు విగ్రహం భక్తవత్సలం స్థితం సమస్త లోక విగ్రహం విక్వనన్మనుక్యేవ కింకిణీల సత్కటిం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. సేతు పాలకం త్వధర్మ మార్గ నాశకం కర్మ పాశ మోచకం సుశర్మదాయకం విభుం స్వర్ణ వర్ణ శేష పాశ శోభితాంగ మండలం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. రత్న పాదుకా ప్రభావి రామ పాద యుగ్మకం నిత్యమ ద్వితీయమేష్ట దైవతం నిరంజనం మృత్యుదర్పనాశనం కరాలతం శ్రమోక్షణం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. అట్టహాస భిన్న పద్మ జండ కోశ సంతతిం దృష్టిపాత నష్టపాప జాలముగ్ర శాసనం అష్ట సిద్ధిదాయకం కపాల మాలికాధరం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. సంఘనాయకం విశాల కీర్తిదాయకం కాశీవాసలోక పుణ్య పాప శోధకం విభుం నీతి మార్గ కోవిదం పురాతనం జగత్పతిం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. కాలభైరవాష్టకం పఠంతి మనోహరం జ్ఞాన ముక్తి సాధనం విచిత్ర పుణ్యవర్ధనం శోకమోహ దైన లోభ కోప తాప నాశనం కాశికాపురాధినాథ కాలి భైరవం భజే. కాలి భైరవం భజే. కాలి భైరవం భజే.
శోభితాంగ మండలం కాశికా
ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing. Living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, living and radiating the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness, and Shri Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.